Hello everyone, my name is Ania and today I would like to show you how to make this octagon poncho. It is very easy pattern and all the information about the yarn I use are available in the description below. Thank you very much for watching.
We will start by making a slip knot. So twist your yarn and pull one end through. Insert your hook into the slip knot and make chain four. 1, 2, 3, and 4. This will count as first double crochet, and into this first chain we'll make 15 double crochet. Yarn over the hook, insert the hook into first chain, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two loops, and yarn over, pull through two loops. I will show you again. Yarn over the hook, insert the hook into first chain, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two loops, and yarn over, pull through two loops. In total, counting this first chain three as double crochet, we'll need to have 16 double crochet. So 1, 2, 3. All of them will work into this first chain. 4, 5, 6, and carry on all the way around. At the end, tighten your slip knot and slip stitch into third chain. Let me just show you properly. Third chain, so this chain here, of starting chain four, remembering that this first chain is our ring. I have my first round ready, and in this round I will make 2 double crochet into each double crochet of the first round. I will start by making chain 3, which will count as first double crochet. Into the same stitch, so this third chain of starting chain 3, we'll need to make double crochet through both loops. In the next stitch, 2 double crochet, and again through both loops. 1 and 2. 2 double crochet into the next stitch. 1 and 2. And again, 2 double crochet into the next stitch. 1 and 2. And carry on all the way around. Slip stitch into third chain of the starting chain 3, and at the end of this round you will have 32 double crochet, counting the starting chain 3 as first double crochet. We will start this round by making chain 3, which will count as first double crochet. Into the next double crochet, we'll make double crochet. Chain 1. Into the next 2 double crochet, we'll make 1 double crochet into each stitch. 1 and 2. Chain 1. Double crochet into each of the next 2 stitches. 1 and 2. Chain 1. And again, double crochet into next 2 double crochet from the previous round. 1 and 2. And chain 1. And carry on all the way round, double crochet into each of the next two double crochet, chain one, and repeat this pattern all over, and slip stitch into third chain of starting chain three. This is the last round of making a circle. We will need to make chain three, which will count as first double crochet. Into the next double crochet, and chain two. One, two. We'll skip chain one space, and into next two double crochet, we'll make double crochet into each stitch. Chain two again. Double crochet into next two double crochet. One and two, and chain two. And again, double crochet into each of the next two double crochet. And chain two. One and two. And carry on all the way around, and after making last chain two, slip stitch into third chain of starting chain three. In this round, we will turn our circle into an octagon. We'll start by making chain three and double crochet into next double crochet. Into the next chain two space, two double crochet. One and two. Into the next two double crochet, one double crochet into each stitch. And we will now make a corner into this chain two space, double crochet, chain one, and double crochet again. And we will make the next side. Into first double crochet, double crochet, double crochet into the second double crochet. Into chain two space, we'll make two double crochet, one and two, and into next two double crochet, one double crochet into each stitch. And we will do corner again. So double crochet into chain two space, chain one, and second double crochet into the same chain space. And I will show you side again. So in first two double crochet, make double crochet into each stitch, into chain two space, two double crochet, one and two, and double crochet into each of the next two double crochet, one and two. And we can do our corner again. So into next chain two space, double crochet, chain one, and double crochet again. And as you can see, one side is worked on top of two groups of two double crochet and one group of and on top of one chain two space. And corners are worked into chain two spaces. And carry on all the way around, and at the end, slip stitch into third chain of starting chain three. We will start again by making chain three, which will count as first double crochet. Into the next double crochet, we'll make double crochet. Chain two. We'll skip next two double crochet, as then you can see those two double crochet which we are skipping are on top of chain two. We'll make double crochet into third double crochet. and double crochet into the next stitch. Chain 2 again. 1, 2. We'll skip next double crochet and into chain 1 space in the corner, we'll make double crochet. Chain 2. We'll skip first double crochet after the corner and into next 2 double crochet, we'll make double crochet into each stitch. 2 double crochet again. Chain 2. And we will skip again 2 double crochets which are worked on top of chain 2 and double crochet into the third double crochet. Double crochet into the next stitch, chain 2. And we will be working into the corner and into this chain space in the corner, we need to make double crochet. And this double crochet will be our corner. Chain 2, we will skip first double crochet and into the next 2, we will make 2 double crochet. So 1 double crochet into each of those 2 double crochet. Chain 2, and again we will skip those 2 double crochet which are worked on top of chain 2 space and double crochet into third double crochet and double crochet into the next stitch. Chain 2. And we reached our corner again, so into this corner we'll make double crochet into chain 1 space. Chain 2 again and carry on all the way around, and at the end slip stitch into third chain of starting chain 3. We will start by making chain 3, 1, 2 and 3, and double crochet into next double crochet. And each round from now on will start in the same way. So we will start in with 3 chains and then double crochet into the next stitch. 2 double crochet into next chain 2 space, 1 and 2. Double crochet into each of the next 2 double crochet, 1 and 2. 2 double crochet into next chain 2 space, 1 and 2, and into this corner double crochet we'll make double crochet, chain 1 and double crochet again. Into next chain 2 space, 2 double crochet, into next 2 double crochet, 1 double crochet into each stitch, into chain 2 space 2 double crochet, into next 2 double crochet 1 double crochet into each stitch, so all together 2 double crochet, into chain 2 space 2 double crochet, and we reached again the corner, and into this corner double crochet we'll make double crochet, chain 1 and double crochet again. And again we will start by making 2 double crochet into next chain 2 space and carry on all the way around, and at the end slip stitch into third chain of starting chain 3. We'll start this round again by making chain 3, which will count as first double crochet, and double crochet into the next double crochet. Chain 2, we'll skip 2 double crochet which were worked on top of chain 2, and we'll make double crochet into the next double crochet. Double crochet into the next stitch, chain 2. We'll skip next 2 double crochet, which were again worked on top of chain 2, and into the third double crochet we'll make double crochet. And we are now in the corner. Into this chain 1 space we'll make double crochet, chain 1, and double crochet again. Double crochet into next double crochet, chain 2. We'll skip next 2 double crochet, again which were worked on top of chain 2, and double crochet into third double crochet. Double crochet into the next stitch, chain 2. We will skip next 2 double crochet worked on top of chain 2, double crochet into third double crochet, and double crochet into the next stitch, chain 2. We'll skip 2 double crochet worked on top of chain 2, double crochet into third double crochet. And we reached our corner again, and into this corner space double crochet, chain 1, and double crochet again into this chain space. Double crochet into the next double crochet, chain 2. And carry on all the way around and slip stitch into third chain of starting chain 3. For the next round, up to the final round, we'll be repeating pattern of 4 rounds. And I will show you those four rounds now. We'll start every round by making chain 3 and double crochet into the next stitch. Into chain 2 space, 2 double crochet. And into next 2 double crochet, 1 double crochet on top of each double crochet. And into every chain 2 space we'll be making double crochet, 2 double crochet. And into double crochets, 1 double crochet on top of each double crochet. We have reached our corner space, so we are into chain 1 space. We will make double crochet, chain 1, and double crochet into this corner space. And we will start again. Into every double crochet we'll make double crochet, and into every chain 2 space 2 double crochet. So again 2 double crochet, and into chain 2 space 2 double crochet. And again I have 2 double crochet from the previous round, and on top of each one double crochet, chain 2, and 2 double crochet. Last 2 double crochet of this round, and we are again in the corner space, and in the corner double crochet, chain 1, and double crochet again. And we will start again making double crochet into double crochet and into chain 2 spaces. And let me change the color of my yarn so I can show you how to do the next round and the next corner. We'll start this round again by making chain 3, but I will start with standing double crochet just because I'm changing my yarn, and double crochet into next double crochet. Now I will skip 2 double crochet which are worked on top of chain 2, so I need to make chain 2. After skipping those two double crochet into the next two double crochet. And again, chain two. I will skip next two double crochet, and every single time those will be two double crochet which are worked on top of chain two space. Double crochet into next two stitches. Chain two. And we have reached the corner, and in the corner into chain one space we'll make double crochet. Chain two. And this time we'll skip only one double crochet, and into the second double crochet from the corner we'll make double crochet and double crochet into the next stitch. Chain two. And again in this, on this side, into every two double crochet where which are made on top of chain two, you will need to skip them and make chain two on top of them, and then two double crochet. So skip two double crochet into third double crochet, and one into the next stitch, chain two. Again, skip two and make two double crochet again, chain two. And here again we reach the corner, and in the corner into this chain space make double crochet, chain two. And again skip only one double crochet and double crochet into the next two double crochet, and then chain two. And let me change my yarn so I can show you the next round. You will start next round again by making chain three. I will make standing double crochet only because I'm changing the color of the yarn. Double crochet into next double crochet. Into every chain two space I will make two double crochet, and into the two double crochet following chain two space one double crochet on top of each double crochet. So two double crochet into chain two space, and into each double crochet one double crochet on top. I have my last chain two space before the corner. In the corner into this double crochet, so corner double crochet, I will make double crochet, chain one, and double crochet again. And I will start making into chain two space two double crochet and double crochet into every double crochet. And you will carry on like this on every side. And it does not depend on the number of stitches, as the pattern remains still the same. So into every double crochet, and into chain two space, two double crochet. So I have second double crochet, two double crochet into chain two space. Again, one double crochet and another double crochet on top of double crochet, two double crochet in the corner. And I have corner double crochet, and I will make double crochet, chain one, and double crochet again into the same corner double crochet, into chain two space, two double crochet. And carry on all the way round. And again, slip stitch into third chain of starting chain three, and I will change a color yarn for a new color so you can see better. I have new color yarn on my hook, and you will start again making chain three and double crochet into the next double crochet. Chain two. We'll skip two double crochet every two double crochet which are worked on top of chain two space. double crochet into the next two stitches, chain two, skip two double crochet into next two stitches, chain two. And this will be worked all the way around. And right now I am in this corner space where I made double crochet, chain one, double crochet into first double crochet of the corner, one double crochet into chain space, chain one, and another double crochet into chain space, and double crochet into the last double crochet of the corner, chain two. I will skip next to double crochet which are worked on top of chain two, double crochet into next two double crochet, chain two again, and every single time skip two double crochet and double crochet into the next two stitches, chain two, skip two double crochet into the next two stitches, and so on, until you reach the corner. Chain two, and again I'm in the corner, so double crochet on top of first double crochet of the corner, into chain space, double crochet, chain one, and another double crochet into corner space, and into first double crochet, make double crochet, and carry on all the way around. And I will show you that the first round of the repeat I showed you is going to repeat now. You will start again making chain three. I'm doing again standing double crochet. As you can see, I use the same color yarn as for the first round of repeat I was showing you, just to show you that it is going to be the same. So double crochet into next double crochet, into every chain two space two double crochet, and double crochet on top of each double crochet of the side. The sides are worked in the pattern of two repeats, but corners are worked in the pattern of four repeats. So I'm now before the last chain two space, one, two, and I have next two double crochet before the chain one corner space. As you can see in the previous round, where I started showing you the repeat, we will end, we had double crochet, chain one, and double crochet again. And that is exactly what we are going to do now. So into chain space, we will do double crochet, chain one, and double crochet into the corner, and start making double crochet into every double crochet, and two double crochet into corner, into every chain two space. And as you can see, the corner in this round is exactly the same as corner of this first round I showed you. So you need to carry on until you have 35 rounds all together, and then fast enough make invisible join and repeat the pattern of four repeats for the corner and two repeats for the side. So side repeats in two double crochet, chain two, skip two double crochet, and again two double crochet, and the next side is double crochet into each double crochet and two double crochet into any chain two space from the previous round. For the second octagon, please follow rounds 1 to 34 So make exactly the same octagon apart from the last round. And we will be joining the last octagon as we are doing the last round. The easiest way to start joining your octagons is when you mark the first double crochet where you are going to start joining your octagons. And to do this, the octagon you have finished, so you have all the 35 rounds, we need to put it left side facing us. And from the corner space of the round 34, where you have just single double crochet, so just one double crochet, corner double crochet, towards your right hand side, you will need to count 6 groups of 2 double crochet. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we'll consider the furthest double crochet, furthest away from the corner space. And it might be easier if you turn your work around, and this is this double crochet, and we need to mark the stitch which is worked on top of this double crochet. And this is where we are going to join our octagons. We'll now be doing round 35 of the unfinished octagon. So we will start with chain 3 and double crochet into the next stitch. 2 double crochet into next chain to space, 1 and 2, and double crochet into each of the next 2 double crochet. 1 and 2. 2 double crochet into chain to space, 1 and 2, and double crochet into each of the next 2 double crochet, 1 and 2. 2 double crochet into chain to space. And this is going to be last chain to space before we start joining 2 octagons. In the next double crochet, we'll make double crochet and we will bring forward the octagon which is finished, and both octagons need to be left side facing each other, and we will slip stitch into the marked octagon. So those corners at the end will be in the same place. So we'll make into the marked stitch, insert your hook, yarn over, pull through, and pull through the stitch on the hook. Double crochet into the next double crochet of unfinished octagon, and slip stitch into the finished octagon into the next double crochet. And we will be doing this up until we reach a corner, so let me just show you a few more times. Double crochet, first double crochet into chain to space, and slip stitch into the next double crochet of the finished octagon, and second double crochet into chain to space, slip stitch again into the next double crochet of the finished octagon, double crochet into first double crochet, slip stitch into the next double crochet of finished octagon, double crochet into the second double crochet, and again slip stitch into the next double crochet of finished octagon, first double crochet into chain to space, slip stitch into the next double crochet of finished octagon, and second double crochet into chain to space, again slip stitch into the next double crochet of the finished octagon, and carry on up when you have 2 double crochet into this last chain to space before this corner double crochet, and I will show you how to do the corner and how to carry on next. I have now finished last 2 double crochet before the corner double crochet. I will make double crochet into the corner space and double crochet into the last double crochet before the corner space of the finished octagon. I will slip stitch into this chain space and I will make another double crochet into the corner double crochet of the double crochet where I need to make the round 35. Two double crochet into next chain to space, one and two, and all along this side I will be just making the round as previously. So double crochet into each double crochet and two double crochet into each chain to space, and carry on like this up until you reach this next corner double crochet, and I will show you what to do next. I am now before the corner double crochet and I will make my first double crochet into this corner double crochet. I will connect my work now into the finished octagon. So I will make sure that I have corresponding corner space in front of me, and where you can see on top of this corner double crochet, you will have two double crochet and chain space. You will need to slip stitch into this chain space. Make another double crochet into the corner double crochet. So all the time we are working and making double crochet into this unfinished double crochet, and make slip stitch to the next double crochet, which is on top of this corner double crochet of your finished octagon. Make first double crochet into chain to space and slip stitch to the next double crochet of the finished octagon. Make the second double crochet into chain to space and again slip stitch into the next double crochet of the finished octagon. Make your double crochet into the first double crochet, slip stitch into next double crochet of the finished octagon, double crochet into the next double crochet, and again slip stitch into the next double crochet of the finished octagon. And this space between those two joints where you have finished joining your two octagons up until you started it again will be your armhole. And on this side we will carry joining both octagons until we reach the corner. So again I will meet you at the corner space and I will show you what to do next. I'm now just before the corner space. I will make my first double crochet into this corner double crochet and I will slip stitch into the last double crochet of the side of the finished octagon. I will make slip stitch into chain one space of the finished octagon and I will make second double crochet into the corner space of my unfinished octagon, and all along this side I will be working the pattern again of two double crochet into any chain to space and one double crochet on top of every double crochet, and I will carry on like this all the way around. So one, two double crochet and one more time, two double crochet into chain to space and one double crochet on top of each double crochet, and I will carry like this all the way up to the corner, and I will show you again what to do in the corner. I'm now again just before the corner space and I will make first double crochet into the corner space. I will now connect with a slip stitch to the corresponding corner chain space with the finished octagon. I will make the second double crochet into this corner space and slip stitch into first double crochet of the finished octagon. And again, it's a double crochet worked on top of the corner double crochet. First double crochet into chain to space and slip stitch to the next double crochet of the finished octagon. And second double crochet into chain to space, slip stitch into the next double crochet of the finished octagon, double crochet into double crochet, slip stitch again to the next double crochet of the finished octagon, double crochet into the next double crochet, and again slip stitch into this next double crochet of the finished octagon, and carry on all the way around until you reach the corner. And again, in the corner I will show you what to do, but this space which you now left free will be the space for your head. I will not call it a head hole because it just sounds wrong, but it is a space for your head. So you have one armhole and space for your head, so we need to make another armhole soon. And carry on connecting this side, and I will meet you again in the corner. I'm now just before the corner space. I'll make my first double crochet into the corner space and connect it with the last double crochet of the side of the finished octagon. I will slip stitch into chain one of the finished octagon, and I will make second double crochet into the corner double crochet of the octagon I am making all the double crochets into. Two double crochet into chain to space, one and two, double crochet into each of the next two double crochet, and all along both sides we'll be making two double crochet into any chain to space and double crochet on top of every double crochet. And at the end of this side I will again meet you in the corner, and this is going to be when we will join the next octagon, and this is going to be our second armhole. So I will again meet you in the corner when you just make simple round 35 of this octagon. So we are not joining this side. Before I carry on with last round of joining two octagons, I will count the sixth group of two double crochet of round 34. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I will mark the second double crochet from the corner of the sixth group of two double crochet. So I will just put the marker into this second double crochet into the sixth group. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 group of two double crochet. The second double crochet, it will be easier for you to mark it as we are going to finish joining the next side on this double crochet. I'm now just before the corner. I will need to make one double crochet into this corner double crochet. I will slip stitch into the corresponding corner into chain one space of a corresponding corner of the finished octagon, and I will make the second double crochet into this corner double crochet, and I will slip stitch into the first double crochet of the side of the finished octagon. I will make my first double crochet into chain two space after the corner and slip stitch into the next double crochet and make second double crochet and again slip stitch into the next double crochet. And I will carry on making double crochet on top of each double crochet and two double crochet into every chain two space and slip stitching after making every single double crochet into the next double crochet of the finished octagon. And I will meet you just before we reach this marked double crochet. I will need to make one double crochet into first double crochet of this last group of two double crochet, slip stitch again, and I'm now into the marked double crochet. I'll make double crochet into this stitch and slip stitch into the next double crochet of the finished octagon. And from now on, I will be just working into one octagon, finishing round 35. So two double crochet, one and two into next chain two space, and double crochet into each double crochet. And carry on like this up until the end, into any corner space when you have this corner double crochet, make double crochet, chain one, double crochet, and carry on making two double crochet into chain two space, and at the end make invisible join when you finish off this round, and your poncho is ready.